Hi folks, I'm Steve Hindy for Showing Animals Respect and Kindness. Check out the guy in the white pickup. He's about to commit road rage. On Saturday, September 30, 2023, a shark team was parked on the side of a little used country road off Highway 173 near Poplar Grove, Illinois, in Boone County. We were flying drones to document a rodeo. As our supporters know, Shark has been working to stop illegal, sometimes deadly rodeo animal abuse in Boone County for the last two seasons. As the day progressed, a number of vehicles passed by us without incident. We didn't bother them, and they didn't bother us. Then came this guy. We called the Boone County Sheriff's Department because threatening and intimidating people with a few thousand pounds of automobile is illegal. In fact, just laying on the horn to disturb and alarm people is illegal. Under Illinois Statute Chapter 625, horns and warning devices, the driver of a motor vehicle shall, when reasonably necessary to ensure safe operation, give audible warning with his horn, but shall not otherwise use such horn when upon a highway. From the Illinois State Police website, some examples of driver behaviors during road rage incidents: repeatedly honking the horn. We called the Boone County Sheriff's Department. Unfortunately, the responding officer was Deputy Corey Wright. Deputy Wright looked at our video and decided that because the guy didn't leave the roadway and didn't actually hit us, he didn't do anything wrong. Deputy Wright initially refused to even write a police report until 10 days later, and only after I pushed very hard on his supervisor. When a report was actually made, we obtained a copy. This is the claim from the driver in the report. He stated he did not see them right away and was not trying to antagonize anyone. Look at the incident again. The evening was clear. The driver could see us as easily as we saw him. There were four vehicles parked on the side of the road, so the driver told an obvious lie that anyone could see through, much less a law enforcement officer. But the story doesn't end there. I drove up the road, which dead ends, and easily found the vehicle. Deputy Wright went there too and spoke to the driver. I recorded part of the conversation. Listen to what the driver tells Deputy Wright.
I honked the horn after I went by.
Look at the incident again. It is obvious that the driver is lying. So the driver lied right to the deputy's face, and still Deputy Wright let him off. Like I said before, he didn't even want to write a police report. Can you imagine what Deputy Wright or any other cop would do if someone drove by them and targeted them like the driver did to us? Does anyone believe that the police would just tolerate it? Not a chance in hell. We're still waiting for the Boone County Sheriff's Office to do its job. This driver needs to be charged. As for Deputy Wright, it's pretty clear that he shouldn't be a deputy at all. If you care about equal justice under the law, please contact Boone County Sheriff Scott Yunk and ask him to do the right thing. Contact information is in the description section of this video. Please be professional and courteous at all times, and please let us know of any response you may receive. I'm Steve Hindy for Showing Animals Respect and Kindness.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel to see more of our investigations and learn what you can do to help Shark help animals. Consider sharing our videos so other people can help save lives. If you'd like to support Shark directly, you can follow the donation link in the description section of this video. If you'd like to gain access to exclusive content, consider sponsoring us on Patreon.